Hi, this is Ed with Fax Authority, and in this video we'll be showing you how to fax with eFax through your email system. This is part of a multiple series of videos on eFax, so for more, please see our site, faxauthority.com/eFax. I'll go over this twice, first a quick version to give you an idea of how the process works, then a second version where I'll go through all the features and functions and options that come with the system. Let's say that we have these documents here. One's a spreadsheet, a Word document, and a picture, and we want to fax these from our computer to somebody else's fax number. So all we need to do when faxing through email is open up our email system, select New Message, put in the fax number we want to send to, followed by @efaxsend.com, enter some information in for the subject. This is just for the cover page. Then all we need to do is attach these files to the email. Hit send, and we've just sent our fax. It's actually quite quick and simple to do. Now I'll go through this a second time and go through all the functions and features involved. First of all, you can use any email system with this. It can be Outlook, it can be Thunderbird, it can be Mac's version of Mail, it can be a mail program on Linux, Hotmail, Gmail, Yahoo Mail. Whatever it is, all you have to do is authorize your email address with your eFax account, and then you can send from that email address regardless of what system that's on. When we're sending a new message, what's needed with this is that we can send this to multiple fax numbers. So if we have three or four fax numbers, we can just enter them all separately in the to line, and this will pull the information through. As well, if we want to add some email addresses to this message, we can also put them in here. This is great because a lot of the times we'll have 100 people that we want to send an email to and two or three that still rely on fax. So we can include these all in the same message without having to do two separate actions. As well, the information we put on the subject gets translated over to the subject column of the fax page. The body part of the email gets translated over to the body part of the cover page. So if we put the number of pages in the cover or an action for somebody to do when they've received the fax, we can put this and it'll be on the cover. If we're sending this to multiple people, the other thing is that each of their information will be properly translated over to the fax cover page when they've received it. So if there's three different fax numbers we're sending it to, each of those fax transmissions will have the fax number for that receiver on the fax cover page. So it's not a whole list of everybody that you're sending it to. Now all we need to do is just take these files. This is just a spreadsheet, a Word document, and a picture. Take these and drag it on. There's a lot of different file formats that could be faxed. Take a look at our site, faxauthority.com/efax, for all that information. When we're done, all we have to do is hit send. And this will now go through our system, just as if we'd sent an email and turn up on a fax machine. To find out how this looks on the receiving end, and also for more ways to fax, take a look at our page, faxauthority.com/efax, and we've got all the details right there.